You arrive at a location Aethelings is seeking to obtain. It appears to be a regular stretch of desert. There doesn't seem to be anything special about it. Investigate the area. You spot a single mobile home. It looks decrepit and badly maintained. Approach the mobile home. You knock the door and a man opens it. What do you want? He yells, pointing a scatter cannon at your face. You understand why Aethelsing didn't want to deal with this man themselves. No time for this, just shoot him. You realize he already has his scatter cannon pointed at your face while your weapon is still holstered. If you're feeling particularly lucky, you can try to do this, but you are at severe risk of dying. Fine, let's talk. The man invites you in, says his name is Bad Max, and tells you that he wasn't always a landowner. Apparently he used to live a nomadic adventurous life. You can hardly believe this wild-eyed character was ever adventurous. Ugh. Continue. The man says he wouldn't mind going back to that lifestyle. This piece of desert is starting to bore him. He wants to trade the deed of land for parts and fuel to get his old car back up and running. Sure. Let it go. You give the old man the parts and fuel he needs to get his life back on the road. As you drive away with the deed of land, you hear him firing his scatter cannon in the air and yelling, "Yeehaw! Back to the raping and pillaging for me!" You wonder if you made the right decision. Time to report your success to Aethelsing. Drive to Enterprise headquarters. Okay. Not sure if that was the right choice, getting Mad Max back to the road. I have no money for repairs and stuff now. We'll sell that. And let's get that mine guard. At least one level of that. Viking Desert Nomad. Well, there goes old scrap. Privateers. They tried to speed off after them. The privateers are jettisoning their cargo in order to stay ahead. Several crates of cargo hit the sand. Ooh, so they must be having even more expensive stuff on them. Keep chasing. The privateers keep dumping cargo in an attempt to speed up. You'll have to supercharge your engines if you want to catch up now. Do it! Despite their attempts to escape, the privateers are forced into a fight. Hey, Thriller Gaming. They must be having something nice if they are trying to get that desperately away from me. Holy shit.
What can I do?
Yeah? Let me out.
Holy crapola. That's a lot of missiles.
Yes. Roger, hey.
Yes?
Yes, Captain? Yeah. Attacking, yes?
Yeah?
Yes?
Yes, Captain?
Let me out.
Let me out.
Maybe this was a bad idea. This was definitely a bad idea.
Hey! Roger! Hey! Roger!
Yes, Captain.
Yes, Captain. Hey, shooting the enemy. Hey,
what's behind you?
Hey, burn rubber. Moving. Hey,
so that gets us. Crashing into that.
Yeah.
Achievement unlocked. Destruction.
Let me out. Hey! Yes?
Hey!
What can I do?
Hey, Hey, DF, it's going good.
Yes, Captain?
Ugh. Light rocket artillery. Fuel and some scrap, which probably goes to repair all the damage from this battle. And well, that's nice. Take loot. Ooh. No, this was definitely worth it, Rayman. Not a bad idea. So much scrap. It is pretty nice, if it is. Yeah, this is basically like FTL and Mad Max together, if it is. You arrive at the Aethelskine corporate office and you are told that you were expected. Once again, you are led into the meeting room where Samuel and Maxwell are waiting for you. The old man is gone. Yes, we heard that he left the area. Convincing that gun happy fool can't have been easy, well done. Naturally, we shall uphold our end of the bargain. We are trustworthy businessmen after all. Your stamps are being delivered to your convoy as we speak. Pleasure doing business with you. Goodbye. Before you have a chance to say anything in return, you are led outside the building. Damn businessmen. Well, we have the stamps and the stabilizer now. So we have to deliver those to spaceship, because we have no more room for anything. Actually, is there a camp nearby? 58 kilometers, that's the same one. Let's try to find another camp this way. I should really go to the camp in there. I'm gonna go repair. You come across a lone figure wandering the wastelands. It appears to be a blind man in brown robes. Stop and talk to him. The man looks straight at your convoy despite being blind and proclaims, "Empathy must be limited. Ultimately, the empathic gift blurs the boundaries between hunter and victim, between successful and the defeated." Okay. You are suddenly surrounded by a blinding flash. The blind man has disappeared. Okay. It's a trap. It's probably a trap. Got another one of these. So let's replace that with the rockets. Yeah. Oh. And repair. This repairing is getting really expensive. Sell that. Get to the spaceship now. So how come your car with railgun thing only has one weapon? It only has one red weapon slot. I could put something in the green one. Green one, the yellow one. Book of Eli? Yeah, it has the yellow slot for a... it's like a utility slot. You can put like a taunter there and ramming gear and stuff like that. As you traverse this stretch of desert, you spot several wrecks. Victims of local privateers. Let's investigate the wrecks. Clean. Yeah, these armor points. The signal appears to be coming from a lone privateer vehicle. It seems to have noticed your convoy, starts its engines and attempts to race off. Chase it! Lots of faster, damn. Coming from an old saloon, there are several old cars in front that look like they haven't been started in a long time. There is a foul stench in the air. The saloon seems so still, so dead, so forgotten. Then suddenly a large woman bursts through the saloon doors and she yells and cheers for you and your men to come inside. Let's go inside. You and a variety of crew head inside. Cobwebs and dust cover every surface, except for the stage, which shines like it has been polished every day. On the stage is a young man wearing long jeans, a button-down tropical shirt, and tropical hat. He introduces himself as Michael Fritz and begins telling jokes. A larger woman begins serving drinks to the men. The cups look brand new, like they have barely been used. Liquid in the glass looks and smells fine. Yeah, we are not drinking that. You sit calmly and simply look at the drink. The rest of your men begin drinking it, and within minutes they are all either yelling like madmen or unconscious on the floor. You stand up to help them, but you are cracked over your head from behind. When you wake up, the woman looms over you holding your pistol. Grab your back up and shoot her. She notices your intent and smashes you in the face with the stock of her weapon. When you wake up in the front of the saloon, all your scrap is gone and you find yourself stripped of all your clothes except your underwear. You find no trace of the woman or and the comedian, so you round up your crew and prepare to head out. After donning a new uniform, that is. I lost all my scrap. 87 scrap gone. Ugh. That blows. There is a false stench in the wind. Turns out you've already tarried for too long. The source of the false stench becomes evident. Several raider vehicles approach your convoy. They seem to be decorated with bodily remains. Kill them. Did I lose a fuel too? I may have. If I'm actually running out of fuel, then we are in a deep shit.
Hey! Lock and load.
Yes?
Yes, Captain? Let me out.
Yes, Captain.
Yes?
Yes, Captain.
What can I do?
Down to 16 fuel. Oh, that's not good. Yeah, it looks like this could hit actually multiple enemies. If I shoot it in a good way.
Got him in my chest.
Medium railgun, ooh, and fuel, and scrap. That's gonna help a bit. Yeah, we are really down on fuel. Oof, and scrap. Is there a camp nearby? No, of course not. Let's see if I can get some fuel from there. You come across a raider outpost. They attempt to radio you. Let's hear it. That's a mighty fine-looking convoy you got there. How about you transfer some of our wares for us? That sounds like a trap. Not interested. Your damn bastards won't listen. How about you listen to some damn firepower? Several vehicles move to pursue you. Let's kill them. I'll steal their fuel.
What can I do? Hey! Yes?
Yes?
Let me out. Run it and gun it. Let me out.
Well, that died hey. Quickly.
Yes?
So my cars are very in a very bad shape. I know what to do with you.
Yes.
Hey.
Ram this guy into the canyon there. Boom. 12 fuel and some scrap. There's a camp nearby. It's not very near though. We should really go here first. Let's go to the camp. I need fuel really, really badly. Pelona use RAM, it's super effective. It was pretty effective. This area is littered with the vehicle wrecks. Best get out of here. As you spot several gruesome vehicles racing. I'm in a risk of losing our vehicles on this battle.
Let me out. Roger.
Yes.
What can I do? Yes. Lock and load.
Yeah, they are quite powerful, the bigger ones. Five-wheeled ones.
Yeah.
We should steal one. I really want to get that car you could have gotten from the stadium mission. It was really nice.
Yes, Captain.
I had it when I was trying the game myself. And it was powerful. This puts me in mind of that homework game that was going to be cars instead of spaceships. Yeah, Alien Pickle, it does actually. I'm actually absolutely looking forward to that game because it sounded very, very nice. Fuel and scrap, thank you. I'm not sure if I can make it to the camp. If there's gonna be more fights, we are gonna start losing people. So what do we still here? Nothing. I have the medium railgun now. Not the best damage, but ignore shields. It's still 50 damage, which is quite a lot. It's actually the most powerful gun we have at the moment. Let's change that into the railgun. Sell that. Shipbreakers, yeah. Let's buy some fuel as well. All that beautiful scrap gone. At least we are now in full shape again. Let's go drop the quest items. More wrecks. Oh, medium rocket artillery and a leech drone. I'm tempted to go back and put those on. Nah, we'll put them on once we've delivered these. I'm really low on fuel. Not really happy about that. Hey, Iron Man. There we go. Crates delivered. So that's done now. Compression coil is that way. Let's go to the compression coil next. As you drive around the abandoned city, you realize all these alleyways and streets would be a perfect ambush location. Keep your eyes peeled. There doesn't seem to be any activity. It's always good to be prepared though. We should use the roads because it's faster to drive through those. The radio pickups chatter. Okay man, they'll drive by any moment now. The radio silence until they are here. Let's go.
Yeah.
Good start. These are Torvak. These are the high-tech guys. They have pretty long range weapons, Roger. It seems.
Yes, Captain?
Hi. Look at
hey.
Me. Let me help.
Hey. Yes, Captain?
EMP in my own car.
Yeah. Going in.
Hey.
Yeah. What can I do? What can I do?
Almost a perfect chance to ram that. Yeah, I haven't heard anything about that game either for a long time, Zigaris. Yeah. I wonder what happened to it. Thank God there was nothing coming in this lane while I was down there.
Yes, Captain.
Well,
yes.
Hi.
Hey. Yes, Captain.
He just drove in there. Oof. What a treacherous area. So much of these skull areas. Scrap fuel. You commend yourself the fact that the traders don't ambush anyone else in the future. Take loot. It's still in dev. I know the guy who wrote the dialogue for Homeworld 1 and 2 and he's worked with them some. Nice alien pickle. Nice. Hopefully it's gonna be a good game because the whole setting and the idea is very, very interesting. Without warning, you are surrounded by Torvak vehicles. You have no idea how they managed to avoid detection by your scanners. There is no chance to escape.
Yes.
The big car in the back doesn't look friendly at all. That insta exploded. It's actually very, very in a bad shape. He also wrote Disney's Treasure Planet game.
What can I do?
What can I do?
Seems like a fitting game to do than.
Hey.
If you need a Treasure Planet too. Are those drones? Yes, they are, Zigaris. Leech drones and probably some other kind of drones as well. I really want to get a leech drone for my main vehicle as well,
yes.
So we get the leech some health every time. And basically repair the car without having to go to a repair shop. Scrap and fuel.
Yes, Captain.
I have a lot of scrap again and fuel, but I'm also in a very bad shape. 145 kilometers. Ugh. Let's hear it. Greetings. We are in the process of establishing a new checkpoint in these lands. However, due to unforeseen circumstances, we need to construct additional pylons. We can't spare the vehicles to transport the pylons ourselves, which is why we have hailed you. We will reveal the location of our pylon construction facility and allow you to work for us. We believe you should. More checkpoints? I'd rather we had none. One less. I might die on this battle, actually. That's a lot of firepower.
Shooting the enemy.
Hi.
Yes, Captain? Yes.
And my main vehicle is in a so bad shape at the moment.
What can I do?
Can you stop shooting my main vehicle, please?
What can I do?
It doesn't like that.
Rolling. Yes, Captain?
Hey!
You? I've got him in my sight.
Let me help!
Yeah, this is the death.
Definitely.
We have like one hit point or something left. Game over. Game over, man. Oh well. Is that from the battle? Let's do a new game. Did we unlock anything? No, we didn't. Let's try the other MCV I have locked. With the missile. What is the stats differ? More HP, less AP. Let's go with the dreadnought. We'll do names again. Mobile construction vehicle? I'm not sure if it is. King Beast didn't die like that. Sadly, he died. Let's go TFE this rat. This will be Alien Pickle Knight. I'm keeping the name. It'll be Alien Pickle. And we'll go Zygarius on this one. And this is easy difficulty. There is a normal and hard difficulty as well. Yeah, I know what to do. Let's go explore a bit. Signing distance, free trading. Yeah, we know what that is. This one actually fits three of those at the same time. The other one was only two. Steve Jackson's Car Wars board came to PC, just saying. Let me actually see that Car Wars. I think I have played that board game. I think my wife has also. Car Wars. No, then that's not the one. Something else. That does look actually very interesting, Alien Pickle. We probably do Alien Pickle. We Finns are very into board games. They might, Zygarius. I don't know. It says that they are fighting over control in the areas. So I don't know if you're doing the quests and not doing quests, and over time it changes. So it might become harder over time as well.